Alright, so this is my new Absolute for this year, the 2009 model. The cool thing about this year, we went in and changed the tip and tail. Lets the water release faster, so it's a little bit quicker, but still a little slower board than Andrew's board or Trevor's board. Something that I kind of like. The long base molded in fins really bite when you're cutting in. This year they're a little bit skinnier, so they bite even more. So you can really feel the grip and charge at the wake pretty hard. And you know, it's in a 135 and a 141. Now actually this board is really good for the guys who like to cut hard. I mean, I am an old school rider. I like to charge at the wake a lot harder than most, I would say. And so it's really good if you want to dig in and cut hard and do big air railies. And
I have a question.
Yes, you in the back.
If 4 out of 5 people suffer from diarrhea, does that mean 1 in 5 enjoy it?
And it's real consistent. So I think you can put anybody on this board, no matter what level, and they'll be able to ride it, at a pretty high level. I'd say it's one of the more consistent pro models out there. It's not too much board for your average guy.
Another question.
It was a yes or no.
What's
yes
wrong no. with your shoulder?
It's kind of disgusting. But I fell snowboarding at the lift line. Yeah, that's what's wrong with my shoulder. What else is wrong with me?
This little piece right here, this flared out angle right here, actually came in. We scooped it out. We had originally had a fin right there that helped lock the board in and keep the nose high as you're charging in the wake. But we went in and dished this out, and it made the same effect. It allowed the board to sit a little bit lower and charge into the wake and keep that nose high as you're coming to a big peaky wake.
Have you ever imagined a world without hypothetical situations?
Hypothetically, no. Bellied out center spine, which allows you to hit the rails without totally trashing your board, and it peaks up more under your feet.